Hello everyone, and welcome back to one of our videos. My name is Morten, and I'm an instructor here at FURUNO Maritime Training. Today I would like to take another of your questions and show it on the FURUNO FMD ECDIS. Today we will talk about LOP, which is line of position, or it is where you transfer a bearing you have taken or distance you have taken on the radar or your bearing diopter to the ECDIS. So let's go to the ECDIS. Yes. So when you have taken a bearing and a distance on your radar and you want to transfer it to the ECDIS, then you go to the lock button here in the instant access bar and you choose the event lock here. And then position event. In position event, this window will open up here, and it always opens up as per default on the LOP page. So then you have to set up some things here. You have here a menu here where you have to click down, and when you are doing speed through water, then you use the continuous transfer. The transfer off is if you are lying still on anchorage and you want to verify your position. Transfer to latest, we don't use so much, but this is when you transfer to the latest bearing and distance you have taken. So let's move to continuous transfer. Okay, then you just move this window so we can see something here, maybe a little bit down there. So let's say you have taken a bearing and a distance to a point here on land, maybe this cliff here with the bearings, and then you just click it, and then you see here you get a bearing from your own ship here. If you have also taken a distance, then you just bearing and distance down here. Yes, okay. So then you put in what was your figures from the radar, and then you input it here. Say, let's say that on the radar you took it was 55 degrees and you had a distance on the radar on maybe 7.3 nautical miles. Okay. And then you just press add. And see, now instead of stipulated, it will become highlighted completely. Already now, you can record this position as an estimated position. But if you want a more precise, then you need two bearing distances to get. So let's say you're taking another bearing of, what is it? Maybe here. You took another one here of this one. And then, let's see if it takes it. Yes, okay. And again, you correct down here your, maybe it was 73 and 715, like that. And then you press add again. And now, see, now you have a dead reckoning position, as it is called in here. So let's just press record. And now you see you have here dead reckoning LOP position. This is how you do it. This is also how you saw the other button over here. It said DR. So if you had lost your, let's say your GPS input to your ECDIS, this was a option to update your position on your ECDIS. So this was just a short how you could transfer your bearings you have taken on your bearing diopters or on your radar or your distances from your radar and transfer it to the ECDIS. So it was in log, event log, and I presume, and then you immediately got this LOP. So thank you for watching this small video about LOP. My suggestion to you is that you try this a few times on your ECDIS, because it can be a little bit tricky. So exercise on this in this matter. Again, thank you for writing to me on YouTube and on Facebook. It's really great to hear all your suggestions and all your questions. Look on our webpage and our LinkedIn, Facebook, YouTube, and thank you for watching. Take care, and I'll see you next time in another video. Bye.